Okay, so welcome to Dive to the Titanic. Now this game is categorized as a simulation. Apparently you have this submarine, well of course you have a submarine, can't be using a boat, can we? To dive down and explore the Titanic. What interests me is this game seems pretty original. I can't really think of another game that takes this approach. Also, it has a really cool function or a gameplay mechanic where you're supposed to, I believe, search for treasure, and you earn money, which you use to upgrade your submarine's equipment. So, in my opinion, it falls into strategy gaming as well as being a simulation. And you think about it, simulation games are actually probably the most intense strategy games you can play. Since there's so many variables you have to take into consideration. Now, unlike my other videos, I'm not going to be playing this game from beginning to end. What I will be doing is I'll play a 14 or 15 minute segment, and then I'll play for a while, and then I'll show you guys how far I've come and what's evolved throughout the game. Because to tell you the truth, I'm probably not even going to play through this game. It doesn't really seem like a type of game that I would bother to play very long. But who knows, it seems pretty interesting. So I hope you don't feel bummed out that I'm not going to play from start to end. I think I'll stick to easy. Not usually very good at these simulation games.
Your submarine must be heavily damaged. Another problem is, you're stuck. Do you understand? Your oxygen ran out, probably a leak caused by the crash. Your batteries don't look that good either. Unfortunately, there's more. I'm afraid I can't help you. You have to free yourself. You get me? If you don't make it, then this is it for today. Finito. Done and dusted. Over and out. Your final curtain. You have to free yourself. You hear me?
Okay, I'm back. A 4,000 meters dive takes a while, doesn't it? You've been on your way for almost 2 hours. You should reach the bottom of the ocean any minute now. Let's go over our task for this first dive once again. You have to find the wreckage and then position the four transponders on it. One thing at a time, though. First, we have to find the old lady. Let's do a system check before we kick off. With the N key, you can switch to the cockpit and interior view. X
wow.
Switches the propellers in forward direction.
Looks like
can you
Tron.
Press the X key, please? By the way, you can check the drive on the display on the right side of your screen. You can navigate the boat with the arrow keys. With the upper arrow, you can move upwards. With the lower arrow, you can sink down. With the left and right arrow keys, you can change direction. Press the 4 keys just to check. Okay, it works. Now, let's change the propeller direction to make them go backwards. If you could press the Y key, please, you'll see that the propellers stop. If you press Y again, they will rotate in the opposite direction. Check out if it works. Okay, looking good. To increase the thrust of the propellers, press the Home key. Now, increase the thrust. And now, let's reduce the thrust. For that, please press the N key now. Perfect! It works well. Now, let's do a quick check of the cameras. With the C key, you can go through all the available cameras. Looking good. I'll just do a quick check of the sensors. They seem to work just fine.
All the camera angles,
there's only two.
Once again,
make sure you keep an
eye
on the display on the right side of the screen. It is very important. If any bar on this side turns red, it gets critical. In that case, we better abort the dive before something goes seriously wrong.
Right, okay. Well, thank God it's not a simulation game that takes every aspect seriously.
You could use the sonar to find the lady. To do this, press the E key. You should then hear a ping sound, which is repeated in a certain interval. I've modified the sonar a little bit. When it hits metal, it returns a somewhat muffled ping. The higher the volume, the closer you are.
Alright. Oh, he's quite far away. Let's see, that was the K. No, it was the X. Hooray, let's go full speed, man. Yeehaw! It's not a very visual game, is it now? This could take some time. Whoa, what the hell? Stop.
While you're cruising back and forth down there, remember the currents. They can hit you at any time and throw your boat off course wherever they want. If you're really unlucky, they'll push you in front of a separate part of the wreckage. Just one tiny fissure, and the Titanic claims another victim. Down there, you're dealing with a water pressure of 430 bar. A tiny hole, and you and your submarine will be torn into tatters in less than 2 seconds. This reminds me again of why it's not me sitting in that boat. Furthermore, you have to watch out for parts of the wreck sticking out, and also keep an eye on the wires. It's a total minefield down there. You can get stuck somewhere pretty easily, and then nobody can help you. If you're stuck, you have to free yourself. If you don't succeed, your power and oxygen will run out at some point. You can imagine what happens after that.
Oh, look at that, the ground is getting rough. I guess that's because of the impact. I should probably slow down.
She is. Unbelievable. Now, let's place the transponder. Okay, we'll do it as follows. I will navigate you towards the optimum position for the transponder. The places for the transponders are marked. Once you see the markings, just drive over them with the submarine. The transponder will then be placed automatically. Okay, off we go. Let's start with the first transponder. Further to the south.
South? Oh crap, I'm probably gonna crash. Oh, turn! So slow. What the hell?
Turn to the south.
Yeah, I got stuck. Okay. Turning. Beep, beep, beep.
Turn to the south.
That was me, by the way, not the game. I'm turning, damn it. Oh, hang on, I'm going north. Oh well. Might as well do a full 360, I guess.
Turn to the south.
There we go. There south.
Forwards.
I'm going upwards.
Even further backwards.
There it is. I wonder if I can go full speed at it and see what happens. Oh. That's not really much
okay,
of a simulation.
That was the first transponder. Three to go. On to the next one.
If it was a simulation, it would force me to stop and lower it myself. Not like a Grand Theft Auto sort of thing, where I can just charge my goal and suddenly stop.
Forwards. That in a jiffy. On to the third transponder. A little bit further.
Alright guys, so I'll stop the video
here.
There
are so many stories about
later.
Titanic. There's no end.